jungle. Back on 74. Back on 74, eh? Surely back in 74. Or have I misunderstood that? Anyway, we're getting bogged down in detail now, aren't we? Really?
We often do, to be fair.
We often do. And it's a great record. As indeed is nearly everything jungle ever put out.
It is, you're right, yeah.
Great stuff. Also great stuff new is the new stuff from Emma Anderson, formerly of Lush, but now striding out as
and
a solo...
Sing-Sing.
Yes, indeed. Yep. As a solo artist. Emma is our first, last and everything guest for this morning, and we'll be talking to her after we've heard Bend the Round. The Round is by Emma Anderson, and she joins us very soon to talk about First, Last, Everything. When I say very soon, I mean immediately would have been nearer to the truth. Morning, Emma.
Morning.
Oh, let me make sure you're loud enough. How are you?
I'm good.
Yeah, where are you, Emma?
I'm in Hastings, yeah. In my house, in my bedroom.
Yeah. Just getting a bit of peace and
not
quiet.
Not in bed.
No, well, we would allow that.
I was just going to say, what's it like hearing your records on the radio? Is it still a thrill?
Yes, it is. It's always strange, but And especially now as it's me on my own.
Well, that's what I was going to ask. Yeah. I mean, did you ever envisage being a solo artist, or that's just the way things have turned out?
It's kind of just the way things have turned out, actually.
Yeah.
Don't think I ever envisaged anything, really.
No, because some of these songs... Go on.
No, just take it as it comes and see what happens.
Because you said, like, you would never, in the Lush days, you would probably never have written a song like that, or certainly not written a song for release like that. Is that because it's so stylistically different?
It is a bit stylistically different, isn't it, I think. I don't know. I don't know. I might have done, time, you change as you grow older and your tastes change and your writing styles change and the album isn't all like that.
Okay.
Some of the album you thought was going to be Lush songs, wasn't it, when you got back together for a bit? Some nice people you're working with, like Robin Guthrie there. And I really love the detail that Suede's Richard Oakes is on guitar on that. And the detail I loved is that you did some bookkeeping for Suede.
Yes.
I love that.
I still do.
Do you? So you've got a sort of part-time day job doing the books,
yeah,
have you?
Yeah, no, I'm a bookkeeper.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Mm. Yesterday at one of my clients.
Right.
Great. Well, you just mentioned your taste change. That's kind of at the heart of what this item is about. So let's talk about your taste. Let's talk about your first, and you've picked a brilliant record that you don't hear enough by the Beatles.
Yeah. It's probably one of my favourite Beatles songs. And when I was a kid, I was a massive Beatles fan, but mainly the early stuff. And I think, the films were on the television, weren't they? And I think that's how, as a child, I got into the Beatles, actually. It was for the films.
Where did you grow up, Emma?
I had a quite strange show. I actually grew up in central London, just off Piccadilly, because that's where my dad worked. And we lived in a flat in the building where my dad worked. And in Mayfair, yeah, strange. And,
right, okay.
That must have been quite strange, living in the West End.
Yeah, it was actually. And basically he worked, it was a sort of old boys' army club.
Right.
So quite sort of traditional and, lots of big sort of big paintings and furniture and massive function rooms. And, he had a little flat in there.
Okay.
And,
yeah, well, let's hear a bit of The Night Before and check out these voices. Never gets old, that sound, does it?
It's great. It's great.
It's so great.
1965 in the film Help. That's the first choice from Emma Anderson, who's our guest today. I remember seeing those films and also the Monkees TV show and thinking, it looks great fun being in a group. Was that how it worked for you?
Yes, like all living in the same house.
Exactly. Yes. Wearing matching shirts, going together. Yeah. It looked like it looked great, was it? I mean, how old were you when you formed your first band?
The first band I was in, I didn't really, I sort of joined, it was already going, actually, Rover Girls, which had Chris and Stu that ended up in Silverfish. So I was 19, actually, when I joined that band, yeah.
Yeah.
And then Lush was a couple of years later, so...
Because we first met many, many years ago when you used to come round and give me records at the NME.
That's right, yeah.
Were you working for Jeff at Heavenly, Jeff Barrett?
Yeah, but it wasn't Heavenly. Jeff was a PR and he was mainly doing Creation and Factory.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. So you had all the hip stuff you used to come round with. So and then the next thing I heard, you're in a band. So so tell us about how long have you been sort of sitting on the idea of making a solo record, or have you not been?
Since the last few years, really. I mean, at first, I had, as you said, some songs, and initially I thought, well, I should find a singer to sing, because I'm just not a very confident singer, doing lead. And
sing in Lush, though.
Backing vocals, yeah. I didn't do lead.
You still say it like that, Emma, backing vocals.
No, but I didn't do lead. So then a couple of people persuaded me that I should really, step up to the plate.
How was that? Because I think singing, a lot of my favourite singers, and this is not meant to sound disparaging, but a lot of my favourite singers are not technically great singers, but they have a sort of something distinctive about them, and a lot of it is about confidence, isn't it? I mean, surely we often say when we listen to Neil Young, "Love Him As We Do," surely they would have said, "Well, someone else had better sing," hadn't they? You know. But I mean, but that's the beauty of it, isn't it? There's discovering your own voice.
Yes, indeed, and I'm getting more comfortable as time goes on.
Yeah.
Having said that, I haven't played live yet, so.
Well, but Johnny Marr's on at the Peace Hall tonight. It took him a while to get centre stage.
Well, we'll talk more about that, stepping out centre stage, in a minute. But tell us about Panda Bear and Sonic Boom, which is a recent enthusiasm.
Yeah, it's just a record that I really like for the last couple of years. And it's not original, but it's very original. Do you know what I mean? I met Sonic once because I actually played a gig with him, with someone you've just mentioned, actually, Robin Guthrie.
Do you call him Sonic?
Yeah.
Not Pete. Yeah. I would like to call him
Pete,
Sonic. Yeah.
Sorry.
Pete.
But it was quite a few years ago we did a gig. Yeah. It was Robin's gig, actually.
Yeah.
And Pete was, I was on guitar improvising, which I never do, so I was nervous. And Pete was playing keyboards and the theremin.
Wow.
I've never been on stage with the theremin, actually. Mm. But the curious thing about the show was there was only about 20 people there.
Mm.
It was very odd.
Where was this?
It was
Wembley.
Wembley Dog and Duck. No, it was the Gate Cinema in Notting Hill.
Okay.
So, because there were seats, it didn't look so empty, I think. Interesting. Yeah, I'd like to think if that gig happened now, there might be a few more people.
Yes. Let's hear a bit. Panda Bear, Sonic Boom, Edge of the Edge.
Put it back. You took it out, but you can put it back again. You took a swig and then you take a crack. You're running quick, but you're running off the track. One piece to break the fall, one wave to take us all to the shore. Can't say it's what you're barking for. It's forever at the push of a button. Hidden rock, took a taste and then you spit it back. Consequences of the inside track.
Gorgeous. Really gorgeous.
I love that album. It's obviously channeling a bit of Beach Boys, but I always think that it's the it's Buddy Holly, the psychedelic period he never got to live through. I always think that the Panda Bear and
chosen for us by Emma Anderson, Edge of the Edge, Panda Bear and Sonic Boom. So, Emma, you were saying, you know, Pearlies, Bend the Round is out now. Pearlies comes out in October, and I'm assuming you will be playing live, will you?
Probably, but it won't be this year, it'll be next year. So,
Did you ever, you know, you say you work as a bookkeeper and you've done, you know, so you've had those other jobs and everything. After Lush and Sing-Sing, and before Lush came back, did you always do music, or did you think that was it?
I think after Sing-Sing stopped, which was about 2006, I sort of went through a period of thinking that's probably it, actually.
Mm.
And then...
Did you miss it?
I had a baby in 2010.
Yeah.
So...
that fills some time then.
Very busy.
Yeah.
And then we had the Lush reunion in 2016. And just it sort of started up again. So, no, you know, as I said earlier, there's never been any big plan or... It's just to take things as they come and opportunities or...
Yeah.
And then you will have to step out when you play live, front of stage.
I know.
You don't... It'd be great. Foot on the monitor. It'll all come back to you.
Yeah.
It'll all come back to you.
Have you got a band? Do you know who you're playing with yet?
No. That's why I'm not. It's all very gradual. This. Yeah. So, okay. But all yeah, right. Because it's more or less a studio album. This. So.
Well, we await it then. Pearlies is out via Sonic Cathedral in October. Ben the Round is out now. No, I'm delighted you picked this as your everything, because this is kind of one of my favourite periods of Kate Bush, from Never Forever, her third album. Tell us about how this came into your life.
As a child, I was a big Kate Bush fan. I had this album and Lionheart on cassette, which I used to play on my, you know, those little cassette players with the buttons at the front. Those two albums, but this was my favorite song on Never Forever. It's just beautiful. And yes, I did see her play live a few years ago.
I saw that Before the Dawn at Hammersmith.
It was great.
It was,
but she didn't do the earlier stuff, which is disappointing, but anyway,
I love those early albums more than and I'm sorry she doesn't seem to rate them anymore, but anyway, you've chosen a gorgeous thing from Never Forever, Blow Away for Bill. Lovely to talk to you again, Emma, and we wish you all the best with Pearlies when it rolls around in a couple of months' time.
Thank you very much.
When you're nervous about going out on stage on your own, do you want me and Stuart to stand either side of you doing interpretive dances?
Yeah, no, you don't want that, Emma. You don't want that. Lovely to talk to you
Good
again.
Good luck with it all. Good luck with it all.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Surely not with his summer.
gorgeous Blow Away for Bill from Kate Bush's Never Forever, her third album from September 1980.
Thanks to Emma Anderson. Craig in Glasgow says, great to hear her. Feels like summer by Sing Sing. It's still one of my favourite songs ever. We'll also play that for and say happy birthday to Linda from Baildon, from Gary Elliott and Little Scooter the Jack Russell, and also Rob and Nisha, who are listening as the first time as a newly engaged couple. Got engaged at Whitby Abbey.
Sorry, Mark, I've dropped something on the floor.
Okay.
Well, congratulations. Lovely to hear Emma. And her first, last, everything choices. Ben the Round is gorgeous. Can't wait to see the rest of Pearlies. Great to have her back. So Stuart in Nottingham eating a vegan bacon cob in the kitchen.
Cob.
Not in bed.
I think a cob being hard.
Crusty.
Roll. Crusty.
I wouldn't want that.
Crusty cob.
And Stephen Cambridge says, what time did you say the Northern Soul prom was on? Excitable Mark was saying he saw you on the telly this morning, so I missed
you're
it.
You're on the telly?
Yeah, I think you're in danger of doing it again now, Mark. 7.45, lasts till 9.15. An hour and a half, if you will. So stay tuned. Well, stay tuned. That's on later. We're back tomorrow with some Frankenstein-related stuff.
Indeed we are.
Yep. So get your bolt through the neck ready.
Don't do that, kids.
No, don't.
No, fake one.
How can I help you? Bye-bye. Better about you. How can I